They are simply amazing. I have confessions in another parish. The Advent, we go all over the place to hear confessions, so I cannot even hear the program tonight. I'll probably listen to one song, but I want to welcome you and thank you for coming and thank the children, all the work that they've done to prepare for this night, and for all the musical department here who has helped them. And I hope it'll be a beautiful evening and a beautiful way to start our Christmas break for the children and for you. And again, welcome. Thank you. We're going to begin with a prayer.
We are going to start with sound art, and then we'll have the prayer after that. Sound art is a great organization that comes to our school, and so we're going to introduce you to them. They will start off our show. At this time, the students are going to start to get into their positions. So students and teachers, let's start to get into our positions for our first number, which will be after sound art is finished. Okay, so give us a minute to get set up, and then welcome to our program. We hope that you enjoy it.
So, we're going to open the show tonight with their performance of Winter Wonderland. And some of these students are brand new to playing instruments. Some of them have been with us for a couple of years now. And we're really proud of them and hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Blessed Virgin Mary, Saint Bernard, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Lord, in this holy season of prayer and song and laughter, we praise you for the great wonders you have sent us, for shining star and angel song, for an infant's cry in a lowly manger. We praise you for the word made flesh in a little child. We behold his glory and are bathed in its radiance. Be with us as we sing of Christmas, the incomprehensible comprehended, the poetry made hard fact, the helpless babe who cracks the world asunder. We kneel before you, shepherds, innkeepers, wise men. Help us to rise bigger than we are. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Today, we pay homage to the animals in the stable, those animals that kept the baby Jesus warm on that cold night. We have all of our students who will be performing baby chicks, our piggies, our cows, our horses will be performing a play for you tonight. Before we begin, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for our students and our children from St. Bernard School. Let's give it up. And before we start, I want you to look at one another and say, Merry Christmas, everybody. Say that to each other. Yeah. I knew that when the moon was tragic. So far, so good. Everyone's looking at Mr. Islas. Here we go. What do the big cows do? What does the little horse do?
Wow, love it.
What does the baby lamb say? What does the little kitty do?
Here we go. What are they, my loves?
These are...
Yeah. one more, my loves. Ready? Away.
Away. Thank you.
performing Angels We Have Heard Online and a little Jingle Bell Rock for you. Here we go.
Angels we have heard of high, singing sweetly o'er the plain, and the mountains every climb, echoing their joyous
name. Here we go. Doing something a little different.
Let us welcome the class of 2017, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, Father Perry, Mr. Mercury, and fellow students, and welcome to our Christmas program. This year, the class of 2017 is proud to present our Christmas play entitled Angel Gets Her Wings. We meet John, a loving husband and father of two. He's a stockbroker, yet for the last few months, he's been quite distracted, and unfortunately, his numbers have fallen.
I just transferred 5,000 shares from Mitco to GM. Killed it.
You're kidding me. Congratulations. That's incredible. Then dump it in a year.
Good morning, boss.
John, your numbers have been pretty bad for the last few months.
I know, boss. I'm so sorry. I'll do better. I have some presentations to make tomorrow, and we'll be meeting some new clients.
I'm sorry, John. I'm gonna have to let you go. John, the company's changing. We prepared a severance package for you. It'll at least get you through the holidays. John, I'm sorry. It's not personal. It's business.
John was devastated with the news of his termination. He knew he had to go home and tell his wife this bad news. John was a man of faith, but like any responsible person, he knew this would create a deep sense of worry for his wife and children. Scene 2, home. John arrives, and his wife is decorating the house for the holidays. They have been married for 18 years and have two beautiful children.
Honey, I'm home.
Honey, you're home early. What's up?
I'm not feeling well, so I came home a little early.
John, you left an hour ago, and you looked fine. Let me take your temperature.
Local school students were going from house to house singing Christmas carols. They arrived at John's front door.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Over.
Stop singing! Shouldn't you kids be in school? Get out of here!
John, what's wrong with you? What happened this morning?
I lost my job today. 12 years at the firm and they fired me this morning.
Are you serious? John, we have a house, car payments, kids in Catholic schools. We have bills, John. Oh my God, I can't believe I'm hearing this.
I know. But honey, we can always get a smaller house. We don't need two cars. And the kids can go to public school.
Public school? No!
Enough, kids.
I'm out of here. I need some air.
Scene 3, John meets an angel. John leaves the house and heads for the park where he could be alone.
Lord, what happened? I'm a good guy. I go to church. I'm a loyal husband, and I think I'm a good dad. The pressures of this life seem to all revolve around money and surviving in this ugly world. Lord, I wish I was never born. Everybody would probably be better if I never existed.
John hears a strong wind come out of nowhere and sees a figure come toward him.
Who are you?
Really? I'm an angel. I was sent from above to help you. You seem like such a lost cause. Really? You couldn't just ask for another job or something simple, could you? You really caught the big boss's attention.
God's?
Duh, who did you think? Donald Trump? Yes, God. Okay, Mr. John. You want to know what life would be like without you? Well, let's find out. Come on, John. Time to see the world you never knew.
By the way, where are your wings?
I don't get my wings until I help you. Come on, John. Time to learn.
Angel and John go. Scene 4, the journey. The angel took John through life without him. He was about to meet those important to him in his previous existence. Three shoppers are walking down the street, happy holding packages and in holiday spirit.
David, what are you doing? I went to grammar school with him since kinder. He was a nice kid. We were good friends.
You were never born. You were never there to tell him that everything would be okay after his mom passed away. You were never there to go camping on the weekends with him. He never knew true friendship, so he joined a gang. But you were never born, John.
John and his angel proceeded on their journey and come across John's brother, a homeless, troubled man that has been plagued with drug and alcohol addiction.
Mike? It's me, John, your big brother. I'll help you.
John, you were never born. You were never his brother. You were never born, so he never knew you. And you see, our lives are made specifically to help one another.
You really helped me out. Thank you so much. But how will I know if you got your wings?
Goodbye, John. Someone will let you know about my wings.
John was beginning to understand that his life did matter, that he truly made a difference in the lives of others. John felt new. He was still concerned about his job situation, but he no longer felt devastated. He knew God would get him through this.
Oh my gosh, I gotta get home. It's Christmas.
Scene 5, home.
Honey, I'm home. Sorry. I went to the park last night, and I think I fell asleep. I had the weirdest dream about an angel.
Well, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for going a little crazy earlier. By the way, your old grammar school friend David is in town. He's in the living room, actually. He's in town. He runs his own firm. Maybe you could get a job. And your brother, Mike? He's flying in from New York. He should be arriving tomorrow. He just got promoted. He's getting a new house in town. He's really excited to see you.
Hey, Dad, are we gonna decorate the tree?
Mom, I found the broken angel from last year.
Oh yeah, I forgot to tell you. I got her fixed a week ago. Now, and they put her wings back on. Now she's perfect, just the way she's meant to be.
The end.
Teacher, dear ladies and gentlemen of the class of 2017, take a bow, my love, take a bow. Good job, I'm proud of you, well being. Thank you so much. Give it up for our nominees. Tonight we will be performing for you Hark, the Herald Angels Sing and Burrito Sabanero.
Herald angels sing, glory to
Shall we invite our audience to join us in this next one? What do you think?
You do. You want them to sing, don't you, my angel?
Everybody, I want you to try this. Actually, we'll feed it to you. Here.
Burrito Sabanero, el camino de Belén. Burrito Sabanero, el camino de Belén.
Si me ven,
si me ven, el camino de Belén.
Si me ven,
si me ven, el camino de Belén.
Incredible. You're awesome. Say Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Say we love you.
We love you.
Say we need you in our lives.
We need you in our lives.
Very cool. All right. Oh, come. Ladies and gentlemen, our beautiful little piggies will be singing two songs for you tonight. They will be singing a Christmas iconic favorite entitled, Oh, Come, All Ye Faithful. And they will also be singing for you tonight a Castilian Spanish tune called Fum, Fum, Fum. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for our little piggies. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2018 are cows tonight, are paying tribute to his mother. She said yes.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The angel Gabriel was sent to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a named Joseph of the house David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of reading this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. And of how this kingdom will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with the man?" And the angel said in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for who is called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." The angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Ladies and gentlemen, our seventh grade class will perform for you, Mary, Did You Know?
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would someday walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby
time is it?
It's Christmas time.
Say Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for our fourth grade class right now. These are our actors in the major. This day will be the class that you know sing a vocal. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight we'll be performing two very cool songs. My Favorite Things, and Do You Hear?
One, two.
Who's back?
We are.
Who's back?
We are.
Take a bow. 1, 2, 3. Before you can...
Meow.
Oh.
Meow.
Let us welcome our fifth grade class as they present a beautiful traditional carol entitled, What Child Is This? And something very, very unique and interesting as we bring it up. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up. These are our dogs.
Ruff.
Ruff.
Ruff. Ruff. Ruff. You scared me.
Oh, man, man. Good. Male personality.
Santa Claus.
I Let's give a big round of applause to all the students at St. Bernard. Great job performing. I just have a couple of announcements, parents. I'd also like to thank all of the parents, especially the room parents, for all of your hard work in putting together the costumes. Let's give all room parents or parents involved a round of applause. And thank you to the teachers. The teachers put in a lot of work for a show like this. Thank you, teachers. I must say, in any Catholic school, this is a very stressful week. So the teachers have done a great job of dealing with all the stress of a program and conferences and everything. I'd also like to thank this man right here, Mr. Islas, for all of your hard work. Thank you. And thank you, John. Thank you, John, for accompanying. John Gonzalez, thank you so much. We do have refreshments in the hall, but before you go, I would like to just say this. We are going to have all classes dismissed from their classrooms, except for TK and K will be in the hall. Let's give them a moment to start going. It'll be much safer if we just give them a couple minutes. They're starting right now, but it does take us some time to safely get back to classes. I hope that you do join us. And parents, this was announced from the yearbook staff. They would like you send them any photos that you have. And I would like to say Merry Christmas to everybody, wishing you a great holiday with family and friends. God bless you.